Hello friends, welcome to this session. In this session we will try to solve some of the numerical problems on the Rankine's formula. So that Rankine's formula and their related terms we have studied in the last session. So in this session we will solve the numericals based on the Rankine's formula. Let us take one small problem onto the Rankine's formula. A hollow cylindrical strut with external diameter 80 mm and internal diameter 70 mm is tested in compression, is tested in direct compression and fails at 480 kN. If the same strut tested for both ends fixed over the length of 4 meter, the axial load of the collapse is 280 kN. Find the value of Rankine's constant small a. So this is the problem, and this problem we will solve by the formula Rankine, which is given by Rankine. Okay, so already we know the Rankine formula. So first of all we will try to understand the problem, and whatever the different quantities are given in this particular problem, and also some of the values we have to determine. First of all, there is a hollow cylindrical strut. As we know that strut and columns are the compression member which is subjected to compressive load, that's why it is called as a compressive compression member. So hollow cylindrical means there is a external diameter is 80 mm is given, internal diameter small d 70 mm is given, and this hollow cylindrical strut is subjected to direct compression, and because of the direct compression it fails at a load of 480 kN. Means there is a critical load is 480 kN. And in the next statement, if the same strut is tested for both ends fixed over the length of 4 meter, the axial load of the collapse is 280. So this is the second statement in this problem. So we have to find the Rankine's constant from the given data. As we have already stated that as both ends are fixed, that's why the effective length is exactly half of the actual length, right? So effective length is determined, the actual length is 4000 mm, so that's why the effective length is 2000 mm or 2 meter. So cross section area we can determine, though it is the hollow cylindrical strut is there, so pi by 4 d square minus small d square, right? So capital D is 80 square, small d is 70 square. So cross section area is 1178.097 mm square. After that, moment of inertia we can determine as per the hollow cylindrical strut. So moment of inertia formula is pi by 64 d raised to 4 minus small d raised to 4. So both the d or both the diameters are known. So if you put the values of diameters, you will get the value 832031.818 mm raised to 4. So this is the moment of inertia we have determined. After that, we required radius of gyration k. So k is equal to under root of I minimum or I least value. So this I is always least. So I minimum divided by cross section area and whose whole under root. So k least value will get 26.58. if you put the I minimum value and cross section area is already given. So as the crushing load or critical load, because of the direct compression, that column is failed due to direct compression, and that failure load, or we can say the critical load, is given, that value is 480 kN. So you can easily determine the crushing stress sigma C is equal to PC divided by PA. So PC is the crushing load, sigma C is the crushing stress, and cross section area of hollow cylindrical strut. So crushing load on which that column has been failed because of the direct compression. So that direct compressive load, the value is 480. It is converted into Newton,
multiply by 10 raised to 3. So cross section area value is put here, and if you take the ratio, we'll get the value 407.436 Newton per mm square. So this is a direct direct crushing stress, or we can say crushing strength of this strut sigma c. So after that, in the problem they ask about that to find out the Rankine's constant. So for that we have to use the Rankine's formula. Already we have derived the Rankine formula. So first of all, you write down the Rankine's formula. This P, it is a critical load, or it is sometimes also called as a Rankine's critical load, right, is equal to sigma c into a divided by 1 plus small a under in bracket le divided by k bracket square. So le is the effective length, k is the radius of gyration, least radius of gyration or least lateral dimensions, it is also called. Sigma c is the crushing strength or crushing stress, cross section area capital A. So all these values you can put, because only one unknown is there into this formula, that is a small a, that is a Rankine's constant. So p, that is a Rankine's critical load or Rankine's crippling load value is given in the problem. You can see in the problem that axial load for the collapse is 280 kilonewton. So you can put the value of p 280 kilonewton, or you can convert into newton by multiplying 10 raised to 3. Sigma c, that is the crushing strength of the strut, is given. It is determined 407.436 into cross section area 1178.097. Effective length we determine because of the both the ends are fixed, so that's why the effective length is half of the actual length, which we have determined 2000 mm. Divided by k, that is the least radius of gyration, also we have determined. So you can put all these value and you can solve this particular relation, and you will get the small a value 1.2614 into 10 raised to minus 4, or you can take the ratio in the form of 1:7930. Okay, so this a, it is converted into the ratio of 1:7930. So this is the ratio, or we are commonly we can show the Rankine's constant in terms of 1:7930. The value 7930, in terms of that value we can show, right? So this is the Rankine's constant. In the problem they ask only the Rankine's constant. So by this way you can determine one by one all the terms, and whatever required value is there you can determine by using the Rankine's formula. So this is a problem which is based on the Rankine's formula. Next problem we will take on the same Rankine's theory or Rankine's formula. Find the greatest length of mild steel rod 25 mm by 25 mm which can be used as a compression member, with one end is fixed and other end is free, to carry a working load of 50 kN. Allow FOS, factor of safety is equal to 5. Take small a, that is the Rankine's constant, is 1:7500, and crushing stress symbol is sigma c, is 320 newton per mm square. So in this this problem is also for the Rankine's theory or Rankine's formula. So in this problem they ask about find the greatest length of the mild steel rod, so whose cross section is given. So from that cross section we can determine the cross section area. Though this cross section is square, because both the length are same, 25 25, so 25 multiplied by 25, 625 mm square is the cross section area. Crushing strength is given 320. So as the condition is given, one end is fixed and other end is free, so our relationship between effective length and actual length is effective length le is equal to twice of l. Okay, effective length is double of the actual length, and also the working load means critical load is given 50 into 10 raised to 3 newton, factor of safety is 5, and Rankine's constant is 1:7500, right? So now we can write first of all the Rankine's formula or Rankine's crippling load P is equal to sigma c into a divided by 1 plus small a in bracket le by k bracket square. So we required in this formula sigma c, that is a crushing strength, which is given 320, cross sectional area we have found out, small a, that is a Rankine's constant, is also given in the problem, effective length we determine, which is a double of the actual length, and k, that is a least radius of variation or least lateral dimension, or this k can be determined by using the formula under root of I upon a. This I is always least or this I is minimum. That's why you can also show this I by I minimum. So I minimum divided by cross section area. So I we can determine because this rod is the square rod. So by moment of inertia for the square rod is BD cube by 12. So B and D are same here. So you can use that formula for moment of inertia, and you can determine, and cross sectional area is also given. So if you put all the values here and in this problem, so you can easily determine or after simplification of this relation, so you will get the effective length 20 cm. You do the calculation on the calculator after putting the value of crippling load, crushing strength, cross section area, Rankine's constant is given, effective length is unknown only, and radius of gyration we can determine. So effective length after calculation you can check by doing the calculation, it is a 20 cm. The answer is 20 cm. So actual length also we can determine because we have the condition, actual length is exactly half of the effective length. So actual length is L is equal to 10 cm. Okay, so this in this way you can solve this particular problem, and this problem is based on the Rankine's theory or Rankine's formula. So by using the Rankine's formula you can solve this, and you can finding out the whatever the finding greatest length of the mild steel is there required. So from that formula you can determine, right? So I hope you understood these two small problems based on the Rankine's theory or Rankine's formula. So thank you very much.